Greetings and welcome to episode 29 of my Empire Total War Darth Mod Great Britain campaign. And this, my friends, where we left the last time, where we have finally, my friends, finally at last got ourselves into a position where we can start looking at launching our attack against the Poles, which we've been planning for such a long time, which we've been building towards for such a long time, which we have absolutely given so much of our economy over towards getting these armies into place. And our economy is now starting to feel the strain of this going on here now. So what we have to do, we have to cut our cloth accordingly here. Now, we have last episode began to recruit quite a considerable amount of sort of units here. Now, I've been giving this some thought. We're going to allow the cannons to go through because some of these armies still need some cannons into them to sort of give them that extra firepower. But we're actually going to stop the recruitment of these heavy cavalry. I think we can probably manage with the heavy cavalry for the moment. Now, that's a strategic call on my part, just to try and keep down the sort of overall cost. Look at this, we've got like six of those in production here. Look at that, we've already freed up quite a bit. And also, it'll look at that, our economy there is going to really suffer the income there if we allow those to go through, especially in the upkeep. We might even go into negative, you know, into a sort of recession, as it were, which really will hit us pretty hard here. So we want to try and keep a bit of a bank here if possible, just in case things don't go quite our way. Let's make sure we've got enough sloops here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Indeed we do. I think we'll probably just build another sloop. We've actually also got another first rate. We'll allow that to go through just to give the fleet that we're leaving back in Britain that extra bit of oomph, that little bit, extra bit of firepower here. This is the naval task force going. Look at that. What a magnificent sight. Look at this. Victory is going as well into the Mediterranean. It's going to shadow the transport ships as they move through the Mediterranean here. Just keeping, you never know, just in case. But before we do that, we're also sending this scout ship here. But of course, we've got Russia blockading us here, which is an absolute menace, it really is. Now, a number of excellent, excellent advice has come through. It really has. Your advice has been exemplary once again, my friends. It really, really has been absolutely phenomenal. Let's go check that. Oh, that's a blistering fleet there. And many of you, a lot of you are saying, Mala, you need to remove Genoa at the same time as you attack the Poles. Otherwise, Genoa is going to give you a lot of trouble. So I have taken your advice, my friends, and I'm going to do that. We're going to dedicate one army in this upcoming battle, this upcoming invasion, to taking Genoa here, or Genoa. And as you can see, it's a walled city. Now, we don't know what's here. So it depends on what is here. Now, if there is a huge amount of troops here in Genoa, what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to carry on our attack as normal in Poland. What we'll do, once we've secured Poland, we will then divert forces to taking Genoa. Or if they've only got a small garrison in Genoa here, there's only a small amount of armies, we'll divert an army. That will take care of Genoa and move into Genoa and take care of those. Genoa have also got here Corsica as well. So we've got to be careful here, we don't sort of get hit here, but we've got to try and blockade this port at least, not let them allow them out there. Just look at that, it's a massive amount of money coming in there for France. And also, as many of you spotted last time, actually Poland has taken Moria here, so in fact they're growing stronger in the south here. But indeed, this gives us a much, much bigger opportunity here. If we can take Moria, look at that, they're already upgrading all these facilities, which will cost us absolutely nothing when we get there. They've already upgraded all of these to the maximum you can get here. All these towns have been completely upgraded. We're looking at steam-powered cloth mills. We're looking at everything you get here is absolutely the most you can get here, technology-wise and money-wise. Now, you've also come up with an excellent suggestion of trying to get military access with France. We can sort of help each other, as it were, move through each other's territories if the worst comes to the worst. But we're also going to be focusing definitely here. Our plans have not changed here not one iota here. But let's see if we can still get France here as a military access. Let's try it. No, it doesn't look like we're going to get that at all. Indifferent to us here, friendly, very friendly. Ottomans are indifferent, which is fine. I don't really have a problem with that. Poland, they're very friendly with us, but we've got to do this. Protectorates of Courland. Now, that's going to be a problem. As I hadn't really noticed, Courland is a protectorate here of Poland. And they've got a considerable amount of fleets here. Are they at war? Look at Courland. They're at war with Prussia and Sweden, so that means they may send these fleets down here, and they've got quite a lot of fleets, and they've got a massive fleet in here. So that really does leave us quite vulnerable here, because they're not at war with France at all. So we might have to put our money here into another first-rate ship here. I think that's what we're going to have to do. We're going to have to do that just to bolster this fleet here. We can't allow Courland to really hit us pretty hard here in Britain, especially if we're sending this force here into Poland. But that's a chance we've got to take. We've got to take that chance. We need to get this ship in here, this spy ship, into the Mediterranean. The Russians are blockading here, which is not doing us any good. We can't get past the Russians here at all. Whilst they're blockading Gibraltar, the Gibraltar Straits. We need to find out what's going on here, especially around here, to know what we're up against, and Genoa as well, so we can plan for what our operations might be. And the operation name, Operation Trident, General Jamie came up with that, of course, an excellent, excellent name for an operation, and we're going to take that, we're going to run with that. And indeed, before I forget, my friends, I have named... many of you have asked for it, the generals now. So we have a number of generals here. Now I'm going to explain my decision making here. Now the first general I've got here is for this sort of small strike force here, but it's going to be turned into a full army once we get sort of land settled in Poland, once we've done what we need to do. Now this is General Alexander Larsen. General Larsen, of course, many of you know General Larsen. Excellent commander, excellent field commander, wonderful strategist. And I just want to let you know, Alexander, this is not any sort of, you know, sort of casting down upon you, my friend, because I haven't given you a full army. This is in no way am I sort of putting you down because I haven't given you a full army at all. It's just merely I've tried to give everybody who's asked for an army the army they want, and I've done it in sort of you know, first come first serve, sort of those who've asked first got the armies first. But this in no way is me sort of criticizing you or putting you down any way, Alexander, my friend, not in one way, because I haven't given you a full army and it hasn't got elite troops in it. As soon as this army will be going to Poland, and as soon as we take sort of, you know, Istanbul and that, we got the facilities here to create the elite troops and more troops and cannon and that, this army will be retrofitted into a full elite army. But at the moment, we just can't stretch that at the moment. But I still wanted to include you in this sort of invasion because you've been such a wonderful advisor as well and a commander in the field. So please don't think this is any disparity on you or putting you down anyway. It really isn't, my friend. It's just the sort of the way the sort of things have gone. I haven't got the troops, and we haven't really got the money to afford the troops to fill this in. But that will be taken care of in the future, I can promise you. We've also got here, the next arm we're looking at here is General Drew Cobb. Now General Cobb here has absolutely been a fantastic advisor as well, excellent field commander, and we are going to probably be fitting out General Cobb's army as well. With another, we're missing another regiment here, so we might have to move some regiments around here just to fit in, but we'll probably leave this army. This is quite a powerful army already this year. It's got some excellent troops, lifeguards, it's already got Royal Highlanders, it's an experienced army anyway. It's got three cannon as well, which is always good. So that's General Cobb's army here. And then we have over here waiting here General Cade Mendoza. As you can see, this is a pretty equipped, well equipped army here. We've got two Scottish Highland Red Independents, three lifeguards, two Coldstream Guards, and we've also got three cannon. So this is a pretty big hitting. We've got the Royal Welsh. We'll probably actually move the Royal Welsh into this army here of Drew Cobbs. So we're just gonna, I want everybody to have a fair crack at the whip here, so we're gonna have to, we'll move that into here. Because we want to try and balance out these armies. We don't want one commander to have all the best units. I've been trying to balance them out before I started recording this. I'm trying to balance out the army so everybody, you know, sees they are getting a fair crack at the whip here. I don't want anybody to think I've got favourites. I don't do favourites, my friends. I don't have anybody as sort of a favourite. I treat everybody equal and even, and based on what you sort of, you know, the more you sort of the wonderful contribution you give, the sort of the higher you sort of you get promoted, as it were. So I'm trying to give everybody even sort of armies here. I'm trying to make everybody be fair and even. So that's what I'm trying to do here with these. And sometimes it doesn't always work out, because maybe one of you might think I'm giving more to another, but honestly, that is not what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to be as even-handed as I possibly can here. So we've got General Cade Mendoza. Cade has really been an absolutely fantastic advisor, really has wonderful plans coming out of Cade. Then we have here, we have General Adam. Now I really do apologise for you pronouncing your surname. I'm really loath to pronounce it, because but I think it's Urhunuk, but if I've said that wrong, I probably have. I probably absolutely ruined your surname. I do apologise. I don't mean to do it, my friend. But as you can see here, Adam here has got a well-rounded army here. We've put a couple of elite units in here. We've got still got two regiment of horse, but we have put a lifeguard heavy cavalry to give it actually a bit of oomph, a bit of firepower. And we've got three cannon as well, which give it a good support. And then we have here General Jamie. And again, this is already an army that was already in situ. Very experienced army indeed, extremely experienced. Got three grenadier regiments, a lot of line infantry, three cannon. We've got the 33rd foot in here, we've got a lifeguard. And that is, it's a well-composed army in terms of having a lot of troops available to it. And then we have here General DJP, really has been a wonderful advisor. So has General Jamie as well, been brilliant advice, lots and lots of advice. Jamie actually came up with the name for the operation. Then we've got DJP as well, always a wonderful advisor, great field commander. And as you can see, and DJP asked specifically for a Royal Irish Regiment to be put in to sort of honour his ancestry and his heritage, so I've done that for him as request. As you can see, I've also put in a lifeguards, we've got two Royal Highlander Grenadiers, but as you can see, this really is an absolute battle-hardened army. It already has seen quite a lot of action on many fronts. As you can see, a highly experienced army indeed. We're probably going to remove the Colonial Dragoons and put them into London, and we're going to have three cannon. These three cannon here we've got lined up here are going to be going into DJP's army, because I feel that it needs that fire support. So this Colonial Dragoons will be going into London, and then we should be putting those three cannon that are currently in production into this army before we move out. So that's pretty much it. Now, anybody wants another commander or general command of an army, please let me know, my friends. I will definitely do my best to get you into the army once we've got more armies created. It's going to take a while to get those armies up and running, because of course we're going to be at war for a long time with Poland, so we might struggle sort of financially if things don't go quite our way. If we do get sort of raided quite hard here at the ports, then we could find ourselves struggling for money. But that, you know, if we lose Poland as well, that's a pretty big income of ours is going to drop pretty significantly, so we've got to try and find that balance, as it were. But we can see what we can do. But that is what, that's the composition, my friends. I hope all of you are happy with the armies I've given you. If you're not, please let me know. I can try and sort of juggle things around, try and get the armies better balanced. But for the moment, that's how it's going to stay until we have landed in Poland. We've sort of, you know, if the operation goes well and everything goes smoothly, then we can rejig those armies around a later date, and we can also start increasing them. Of course, we've got guard units coming out eventually once we get our technology up to that thing. I know some of you asked for sort of the, I think, 16th or 18th Regiment of Dragoons to go into, or some of your armies, that will be done as well. But our main focus must be this invasion, this attack that's been building for a number of years now. It really is important we do this. So, I think we've done all we can do now. Our main goal now is to get into the Mediterranean. I don't like what's happening here with the Spanish. Where is Spain? They're friendly, but who are they at war with? They're at war with Sweden, so they may be going for Sweden. So we have to see what happens with that. But I think we can end this turn here. We've got platoon firing en route, and we've also got a steam engine here. But ideally with quicklime would have been fantastic, but we've just got to focus on what's important. We need to get Army Staff College. When we get Army Staff College, we get horse guards, which I will definitely be putting into these armies. Look at that, and guards regiments as well, which we'll definitely putting in there. So if you haven't got elite units, you will be getting them, because we'll have these two coming out very, very soon, and they will go into the armies. Specifically, General Larson, your army will be fitted with guards and horse guards. So hope that is okay, my friends. Anyway, right, let's end this first turn here. Let's see what happens. Let's see what is thrown in our way. Well, let's see what will go our way. Things haven't always gone our way. At one point, we were on the absolute brink of destruction, Britain. It really was that close. We were on the edge of absolutely being completely decimated. But we managed to hold on, and with your advice, I'd like to thank all of you for your wonderful advice, all of you for your wonderful sort of planning and strategy, tactics, everything. Without you, my friends, we would not be where we are now, and I mean that. We would not be in the position where we can finally launch our own assault and hopefully create our own empire here in the Mediterranean and move into the Balkans. and carve an empire for Britain where it belongs, my friends, on the world stage, alongside France and Spain, Russia. So I'd like to thank all of you, because you have helped put this Britain where it is now. You have, all of you, have put Britain now on the map, in the ability to build these fantastic armies, create these armies, put them where they are. Oh, and also, the advice was to create a fishing village, a fishing port in Iceland, instead of creating two naval hospitals. So I'm probably going to do that to bring in the extra food and money. And that should help along those lines there. Now, Russia, what's Russia going to do? Russia's been pretty quiet of late. Sweden, Louisiana, don't do anything funny, Louisiana. Mughal Empire, we broke our alliance with, but of course we need to try and get peace with Louisiana if possible. Ooh, look at that. Militia Iceland, what have we got coming in here? Oh, that's more like it. 5,036. Now we're going to keep things as they are, we keep our money here, because if we have to repair any buildings once we attack them, oh, that's not good there. That's not good there. I wonder if we should really leave this fleet at home and send this fleet in to guard to help. Let's have a quick look here if we can get in there. Yes, we can. Thank you very much, good sir. Now, first thing we're going to do is just scout out Genoa here. Keep your eyes peeled, my friends. Keep them peeled. Oh, hoo-hoo-hoo. They've got nothing here at all. Look at that. They've even got this fleet here as well. This Jeepers Creepers. That's a big navy. And they've got a lot of troops here. That's a lot of army. That's a lot of troops here. A lot of militia, a lot of conscripts. A lot of horse. But if we could take Genoa. Aye, aye, sir. Okay, well, looks like we have to take Genoa out here. We've got Savoy. We've got Spain here. We might give Genoa then over to the possibly to the French. That might give them military access. We need military access with the French more than we need Genoa at the moment. So now we know we're up against in Genoa. We can probably send an army into Genoa here to remove Genoa. And let's have a look what's going on here. This is our main target right here. It's really important that we keep this ship here. Oh, they've got guard units in here. And they're brand new regiments as well. And they've got household cavalry. They got riflemen. They got a lot of cannon. That is a lot of cannon. 15,000 coming in there. Good. Ooh, hoo, hoo. If we move pretty quickly now, we can do this. Don't have much god in Istanbul here. This is going to be the biggest nut to crack here is Patras. Only because of the army they got here, but we don't over too much.
Aye, aye, sir. Heave away, boys. Heave away.
We're going to do something here to keep these under firm control here, right. I think what we might have to do is keep this fleet. We have to take these. What we'll do is we'll take these ships here. We're not going to jeopardise Britain at all. I will not jeopardise the safety of Britain one iota. So this fleet is actually going to remain guarding. That's our biggest port. So actually what we'll do, we'll move this back here, a bit of city we need to do that. And this is the fleet here. We shrunk that fleet down a little bit here, but we're going to take this task force, a much smaller task force here. We've got, whoa, 2823? Ah, of course. We're not raiding as much here, are we? And other. There's only 8386, so we haven't got so many ships on here. Okay, if we put that here. One more turn until that happens there. That's excellent. We're going to build up a bank here. We're going to make sure we're financially stable here as well. Yes. Now these gentlemen can be moved into Glasgow just to make sure that Glasgow is secure. Indeed it is. London is secure. Indeed it is. We've got enough men here anyway. We've got enough ships. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Indeed. Am I counting correct? Yeah, it is. Sometimes my eyes are a bit funny there. Right, so we can start loading some of these up here. No, I won't load these up. I'm not going to take any chances with these at all. We want to make sure we do this absolutely by the book here. So, the first thing is we need two armies to probably take Patras. Because, if I'm not mistaken, will that bring in... No, actually, it just ends here. So, Patras won't have Athens coming in here. But they've got the biggest army here. I think what we'll do is we'll send in General DGP and General Larsen here to take Patras or Moria. He'll use... General Drew Cobb here to take Athens. And the remaining forces, we'll have two armies. So that's, what's that? That's three armies. Two. We'll use General Jamie here. And... No, actually, we'll use General Adam or General Urhunuk here. I'm so sorry for your name. If you can just spell it out for me, I'll definitely do that. Pronounce your name properly. I call you General Adam. We'll use General Adam here to take Genoa. We've got a spare army here then in General Mendoza. Not a spare army as such, because that sounds rather derogatory. But what we might do is we might push on and even take Bulgaria. If we could take Bulgaria as well, what an absolute coup that would be. That would be the coup de grace here. My word, that would absolutely crush the Poles down in the south utterly here. We've got to be careful of Genoa here, especially if they're fleet. So I'm wondering if we leave our... going to move this combat group into here. As soon as we can capture Patras, we'll have access to our own... Now they've got a commercial base in here. Oh, wait a minute. Sofia here, Bulgaria, has two naval hospitals. If we were to take Bulgaria as well, we'd have access to these as well. That'd be absolutely phenomenal. We mustn't overstretch ourselves here at all. We've got to be very, very careful what we're doing here. But I think we've pretty much got our plan of attack ready here. They've got most of their forces on Corsica here. If we can just hold up this fleet inside the here. We've got more than enough ships here to deal with this fleet if it comes for us. But it's also the Courland we've got to watch out for. And there's Courland there as well, see. We've got two more ships here, so we can actually increase our fleet here. Do we take the general, or do we leave the admiral at home? I think we'll leave the admiral at home. I'm just not going to risk Britain at all. It really is the absolute hub of everything we've got. Okay, my friends, this is huge. This 3-9. Oh wait, let's end the turn here. We'll get the guns and then we're going to board the ships. We're going to make our way down to the Mediterranean. It's going to be huge. Poland, what are they going to do? What are they up to indeed? Have they taken any more land off the French? Hopefully not. We've got to try and get peace with Genoa, with Louisiana as well. Come on, France, hold the Polish up here. all the Polish up here. Don't give them any more. What are they up to? What are Poland up to exactly? So they've done nothing here at all, so they're still in the same position. Mukhal Empire. Ooh, anything changed? No, everything's still good here. Look at that, what a wonderful Secretary at War, that is fantastic. What have we got? Ooh, 3225. 14, 20,000, 9,127 coming in. We've got a really, we've built ourselves up a little bit of a bank here, which is good. Minus one happiness, brilliant. Okay. Right.
Your Majesty. Make ready.
Right, so they're going to go into General DJP's army here.
Forward.
Come on, gentlemen, please.
March.
There you go. I've got these. Now that's a full naval force. So this other ship here is going to go into the... Oh, that's a wonderful looking fleet, that really is. But this is what we're using here. We're going to absolutely defend Britain to the hilt. Three, two, two, five here. Ottoman Empire's been hit, Sweden's been hit, and Prussia's been hit. Maybe, just maybe, we can... Treasury is, that's not too bad for the Treasury at all. Navy's pretty good, Army's justice is phenomenal. We can't spend any money here at all in Britain. Nothing additional here yet. I know there's the Ordnance Board, but we are going to try and keep ourselves this money here. There's a bit of surplus.
Yes, Your Majesty.
But now is the time where we board the ships. We need them to be moving out at the same time and moving at the same place. They've got to reach the places where they need to be at the same time. We have to do this really absolutely by the book here. I think the first thing to do is to load up General Cobb, first transport ship. We shall, next to the task force, naval task force at least, and we have, we're trying to put the generals in. Gentlemen, Dozer.
Way anchor.
Further order.
Set sail.
We might as well raid this trade line
deck
here. Well, we can. Might as well make some money until we're ready to move. We've got General Larson. Let's put the ships
any
in
orders
position. Larson boarding the ships. Let's try and make some extra money here while we can before we move out.
Any orders? Ready and
we've got General DJP moving into position.
Ready and
okay, let's raid these trade lines here. And last and by no means least, we have General Jamie.
Under sail. Forwards for crown and country.
All away.
And General Adam.
Set sail.
Ready and waiting for all.
Now I know that some of these.
Orders received and
wow, this is pretty big here. Pretty big indeed. Now first thing we're going to try and do as well is try and get Northeast Louisiana here, and many of you said throw everything you can at them. Throw all your technology, everything you can at them. So I'm going to take your advice. All of it. And many of you said throw money in as well. Now I want peace. Wow, they just absolutely hate us with a passion, which is fine. Absolutely fine indeed. Maybe when we attack Poland, maybe that will change their mind. Maybe that will push them onto our side. Savoy, let's see if Savoy would... I've got to trade. No, they don't like us either, which is fine. Probably get to war with Savoy as well. It's a good chance. But we're going to move out all simultaneously here, because some of these armies have already moved. So what we want to do is we want to move ourselves... Where's the furthest we can go here? Can all of these reach down into the Gibraltar Straits? I believe so. So we're going to send the first of our ships here. We're going to send the task force in first. And we're going to actually send the task force here as a shield, as a guard against any potential attack. Then we're going to send our flotilla, our naval task force here. First ship is on its way. Still ship shape. Outside the Gibraltar Straits, ready to move in.
Any orders?
Nice and neat, please, gentlemen. Just keep your maintain your discipline.
Ship's orders.
And so the Armada leaves Portsmouth. Operation Trident is in full effect. Oh, it's a wonderful sight. Look at this. We don't want to spook the Spanish. We don't want to spook the Spanish at all. We just want them to, you know, be calm. But having this massive British naval force on its doorstep might spook them slightly, but still. Now, where is General Adam? We will send
ready for action. Ship shape and Bristol fashion, Captain. Aye, aye, sir.
I think we'll send General Jamie to take Genoa. He's been a big advocate of us removing Genoa. I think we'll give him the honour of removing Genoa, or attacking Genoa at least. Let's just quickly make sure that everything is still as it is meant to be in Genoa. That intelligence, military intelligence, is crucial here to this. Things are still the same. Things are still the same. We mustn't spook them at all. Whoa ho ho ho. Wait a minute, gentlemen. Wait a minute.
Still ship shape.
That's more forces than we first anticipated here. And they've increased that garrison there significantly.
Ready for action. Ship's orders received.
Okay, so we're going to have to do this the hard way and fight our way into here. We need to capture these here to sort of cut off this Mediterranean redoubt for them. We're not going to move into here yet. We want to do this as we do move in ready. It'll put us... Hang on, where's Jamie? General. Here. We're actually going to send... We've got to watch out the Savoy don't become suspicious. We'll actually put General Jamie here in the sort of this alcove here. Oh, that's a big naval force from here, from France. Not the finest ships, but still packs a punch. We're going to try and move into the Mediterranean here bit by bit. If we can just stage ourselves here. General DJP, we'll need some real tough fighters here. We need street fighters here in this fight, because this is going to be whoa, gentlemen, please. Don't give me that scare there. Thank you. Move past the Russians. We're also going to be sending in General Alexander with General DJP. Together they're going to crack Patras for us. And then we have General Cobb, who is going to be moving into the Greek peninsula and accompanying General Cobb will be we'll have General Adam here moving in on the Greek peninsula with General Cobb. Last, but again by no means least, we have General Cade Mendoza here, who will be fighting pretty much, not alone, that'd be the wrong turn of phrase here, but will be single-handedly fighting into Istanbul. Now what are all these Russian forces doing here? Oh, good grief, good grief, and good grief thrice again. That are some excellent troops they've got here. We have to do what we can here. Yeah, I think General Mendoza can break this garrison here in Istanbul. We have to divert a force into Genoa, but I've taken your advice, my friends. Now we've got to move in this small naval force here. I think we will move just on the outskirts of Patras here. And the French are on the move. If we take Genoa, we might even give it to Louisiana for peace. That might work in our favour. What we need to do is we need to free this army up from fighting in Genoa as quickly as possible, so we don't get caught out here. So make sure the Genoans, once and for all, don't have any other allies. Oh, damn it, they've got the Italian states. We can't take Genoa at the moment. We cannot afford to drag all these allies of the Genoans into it, because I can guarantee the Genoans will be dragged into this fight. What we'll do, we'll attack Poland, we'll see if Genoa join the fight with Poland, and if they do, then we'll attack Genoa. So if Genoa attack, Genoa join Poland in the defense of Poland, we will attack Genoa without having to pull the rest of these in with us. So that is why we've got General Jamie here ready to strike into Genoa. If we can do that, we can might be able to give this to Louisiana, and that might give us break the deadlock. We might be able to get peace here with Poland then. With France, I beg your pardon. I mean, even an alliance. I'm getting my words mixed up here. We've got 11,590, and we probably going to break that down eventually, but not just yet. And that's being built up as well here. We're not going to do that just yet. We're going to build up our bank here to make sure we've got enough here, just in case things go a little bit pear-shaped for us. Okay, my friends, let's end this turn. Next turn, it should be start of the invasion. Let's do this. Jeepers creepers. I got the old sweaty palms here. I don't mind admitting. I don't mind telling you at all. Now what are Poland going to do here? We might see a massive upsurge here in the number of troops they're producing. I know some of you say take Malta as well. We'll take Malta if this succeeds, and if we can take Genoa. By damn, what an absolute fight this is going to be. Ottomans, Russia. those troops have moved away. They've moved away. I know, they've put extra troops here. That means we might be able to do this. If Genoa don't come on the side of Poland, we will move General Jamie's army into attacking Patras and Mart. Look at that. Looks like they've just increased the garrison here. Yes, they have. And also here, they've increased... Good grief, look how many cannons they got here. That is as scary as you can possibly imagine. Okay, hold on to your hats, my friends, because this is going to get really, really, really tense right now.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Let's do this.
Where to, Captain?
First Army onshore, General DJP. Land our troops.
Set sail. Lord. Make ready. Your Majesty. Make ready. Aye, aye, sir.
Can we hold them
here?
It has begun now. Right now, we can attack.
Yes. Weigh anchor. In position. For war.
We're going to go for Genoa. Now that there has prevented us. We should have probably been, mind you, we would have been engaged in an attack straight away.
Aye,
now,
aye,
can we take, we're going to have General Cobb attacking straight off. Oh, look at that, what a wonderful sight.
They hide behind women's skirts. Where to, Captain?
Now, can we?
Aye, aye, sir. In the sail.
Siege them.
They've got a good amount of troops in here. We're looking a little bit short-handed here. So I think what we can do, I think we've got a more than enough here to deal with this. Yeah, I think General Cobb can deal with that single-handedly here. Now that's the choice we make. Do we take? I think we're gonna have to move into make sure we take Istanbul. Simple as that. We've got to take Istanbul. Absolutely as simple as that, my friends. And let's hit these here.
Make ready.
Right.
Officer on deck.
I think what we will do is we'll actually move these here to blockade Genoa.
Ready for action.
We're not going to lose any ships in here at all. Now we can fight the Genoans. We don't want these ships to be moved out so they can transport ships across. Not a chance. Okay, we've got to rely on these gentlemen here. And we've got Courland here, right here. But we've got a nice 1-8-1-8 here. We really squeezed the absolute eyeballs here. But we've got 15,000 in the bank. We've managed to build up a little bit of a surplus here. Look, they're going to be raiding this here. But if they come for us, they've got to deal with this fleet which we've left behind, which is a considerable fleet indeed. We're friendly still with everybody here. Very friendly with France now. I wonder now if... Louisiana would be interested in peace. That seems a bit better response, but we knew we were going to get trouble from Courland and Chanel. But that, my, what an absolute attack that was! It went absolutely perfectly in here. Now we've, I think, because we've got those, got so many guns here. I want to make sure we do capture this. But I've got perfect faith here in General DJP that he will do the duty that he's been asked to do here. We've even got this still being crippled here. Luckily we managed to bring these to battle quite quickly here. But we're going to end this turn, my friends. We're going to see what comes out of this now. I'm wondering if we just possibly put another ship in here. Possibly a... We might as well go for a one here. It's going to give us 1-8, 1-8 here. Right, let's end the turn. And let's see what comes of this. I imagine they're going to probably defend here. Courland, I'd be very surprised they don't do something against us here, but we can destroy this fleet. What will France do, I wonder? Nothing at all. Prussia, Poland, now what will Poland do? Here we go, this is what's going to be the real interesting fight here. What will they do to respond? I bet they didn't see that coming. There it is, my friends. There it is, the first battle here. Athens. Now they're coming to attack us, remember. They've got these rocket troops. They've got a 6-pounder and they've got some 8-inch mortars. They've also got heavy household cavalry here. They've got elite guards. They've got grenadiers. This is a pretty powerful army here. Let's not be under any illusions here. This is a pretty strong army. We mustn't become complacent here. We are going on the defensive. We are not going to be going out to attack them. We need them to come and attack us from behind these walls here. If we can take Greece, then the British flag is placed firmly into the ground here on Polish soil, Greek soil. It will be ours. Let's take this fight, my friends. It's going to be absolutely crucial here, this fight. A cool, calm head here will prevail. It will always prevail. If we remain calm, even in the midst of all this chaos and upheaval, then luck will usually go your way. Remember, luck favours the prepared mind. And my word, we've prepared for this for years. But it's finally come to fruition. And what a fight it will be, my friends. What a fight. The entire sort of future of Britain hangs on these battles here. That's no exaggeration. That's not me being dramatic. It actually does. Let's see what the deployment gods give us here. Will they be in our favour? Will they be against us? Will we be fighting in a town here? Will this be our Stalingrad indeed? Look at this. It's a perfect location. It's absolutely perfect. I cannot even describe to you how perfect this is. We're on a hill here. It's a perfect defensive fortification here. We can establish here. We could put the cannons here and use this sort of mound here as a sort of a way to break up any formations coming towards the cannons. Oh my word, they've got to come out from in that star fort. The star fort has done no good to them at all here. So we're immediately going to shift our axis of a defense here onto this flank here, this left flank. Let's do that here. Immediately being our fire support. I'm glad we waited here. We got General Cobb here bringing the first battle in here. I'm gonna go carcass shot, explosive shell. What's the range for carcass shot? Actually, it's pretty far. That's not too bad. Actually, we'll switch to probably round shot to give us a bit more oomph here. Mind you, that's not really the point. We'll go carcass. We need our initial shots to be pretty accurate. Wait a minute. Wait just a moment, sir. right on the crest of this hill here. I know that we got howitzers, they fire over, but still, that extra elevation, you just never know, my friends. A wonderful sight here. We can hide units in here. Now, can we put General Cobb here, behind here? It's a little bit too... the demarcation line, so once that is ended we will be pulling them back, General Cobb. Now, here's the crucial section here. Now, I think we'll put our Grenadiers in here. 5th Grenadiers, they've been through a lot of fighting, 5th Grenadiers. They're going to be on the sort of the base of the hill here. Look at that! General Cobb has taught his men very well here. General Cobb are fighting a guerrilla general as well, fought guerrilla warfare here, teaching his men how to blend in with the land here, not to be seen, hidden to the last moment. Look at that wonderful, wonderful position. I think we'll have the 2nd Grenadiers, the Royal Welsh here, a proud, proud regiment. Will they be hidden? I'm not sure, but there's one way to find out. Look at that! What, look at these regiments here. It just gives you goosebumps, isn't it? Look at that. If you want a defense, if you want a solid defense, this is the defense you want. Let's just close that up a little bit further there. That's better. And then we'll have the 11th Grenadier Royal Highlanders. Remember, it's all the way from Scotland these gentlemen have travelled. Now they're in the Mediterranean. Now they're actually not going to be hidden, but that's fine. And we can actually use this mound here to our advantage. And then we can bring in the absolutely, you know, the highly experienced red line infantry here. Now which way are they probably going to hit us pretty strongly here from this left, our left, their right. So we're actually going to have a strong 7th Regiment here. As you can see, a battle-hardened here. Regiment, look at that. Really experienced here. Can actually probably teach some of the Grenadiers, probably the Royal Welsh, a thing or two about some brutal fighting. The 8th Regiment indeed. We're actually going to start sort of bending or angling, should I say, these regiments around here. Try and sort of move around here, capture all of the space, the angles we can here for the proper fire. Look at that. Right. No, let's put the 9th Regiment in here. Now, gentlemen, please, no frivolity here. That almost broke up our line here. As you can see, it's like a small hidden sort of cliff here. Can do brutal damage to defence here. I wonder if we might even be able to get some reserves in here, which would be absolutely wonderful to see. With the 18th Regiment, I'm going to start angling the fence around here, shaping our regiments to flow with the land here. Now the 7th is already in line. 10th Regiment, I think we'll stretch the 10th Regiment out here onto the sort of the crest of this new hill here. As you can see, quite a decent sized hill. We want to try and keep our horse in here as well if possible. But I think there's a good chance we can actually get quite a lot of reserves in here. So what we will do, we'll put... Wait, no, that's a pretty big cliff for them to run up. So we'll put the 22nd in reserve. And the 26th as well on the right in reserve. Reserves will always pay off in the end, mark my words, my friends. And we've got the 31st Regiment. Again, we'll put them right in reserve here at the back. We can always move them back slightly here to the demarcation line, away from the line of fire. Got the 40th Regiment again in reserve. Gentlemen, please look sharp here. Remember, your general is one of the finest generals we have here. Do him proud. And last but not least, the 41st. We'll actually put the 41st, I think, on the left. I've just got that sneaky feeling we're going to be hit pretty hard from the left. It's just a gut instinct. We can always shift forces around if need be. We've got a real good, powerful reserve here. Wait a minute. 15th Regiment as well, I do beg your pardon, sir. We'll put these here on the right. That's a strong really, really strong, not only defensive setup, but also a reserve setup here. Now cavalry. Now we got 8th, which will drop down in this sort of mid valley here. We'll also have the 6th. Ideally we like the 6th right over here. I wonder if they'll be hidden over here. If they are, that's where they're going to remain. No, they're not going to be hidden. And so in that case, we shall put them here, and then we'll push them back to here. Or, no, I think I'll keep... No, actually, I think we'll keep our cavalry in one grouping. They're much more powerful together, especially if we try and get flanked here. Okay, my friends, I think we're ready to go here. Salute General Cobb. Wish his troops well, my friends, because this is going to be the first of many, many fights here. Let's do this. I knew it. I knew they would attack us here harder than this flank. Right, let's move our men into position. Gentlemen, please. Regiments here back. Steady now, steady now. I absolutely knew we'd get these from here. Look at that militia. See if we can open up already on these. There they are, there they are. Household. I knew it. I knew they'd push in here. We've got dragoons. A lot of light infantry here. I wonder if we shift down here. I think we probably don't want to be caught here. I'm gonna shift 26 in to just be prepared. Wonderful sight it read. Look at that. What marksmanship. The hussars. If they're in range, we're going to absolutely blitz these to pieces here. They got guard. Oh, that is a beautiful shot. That is a magnificent shot there. Your advice, my friends, once again. We've got to hit these garrison line infantry here. Go on, lads, get stuck in there now. Where are those hussars? Where are they gone? Try and give them hell, lads. We've got a lot of infantry coming in here. They're coming back. Come on, break them now, lads. Get out of there. I've got to take these grenadiers. By damn, we're not going to be flanked here, I can assure you. Keep firing, lads. Well, they have done exceptionally well here. Let's put an end to these. Lads, hold! What a magnificent sight here! Oh god, yeah, that's quite fast moving there. Dragoons. absolutely work wonders. That's a wasted shot. That's more like it. They've broken on this flank here. Oh, now lads. Mind you, these are doing very, very well here. Let's put an end to that. Oh my god, General Karp, I salute you, sir, and your men. You have fought with exceptional discipline and courage, sir. It's time we just ended this fight over here, I think. What a shot that was. The whole line is crumbled. What a fight that was. My word. That was exceptional. Excuse me, my friends. They've broken. But they've paid the price here, look at that. No, actually, let's keep the pressure on this here. What a fight that was. That was magnificent. We'll actually provide a backstop here. We've just lost that regiment here, but we can still repair and punish them. Oh my word, this is incredible. What a fight. Yes, shattered, sir. You should pay the ultimate price right down the front. There, my friends. Don't you dare let them off the hook here. What a fight that was. What the blazes, they've got hussars here. Allow them to escape, I don't think so, sir. Yes, we've got the general. Ah, they've still got quite a lot here. Looks like we're going to have to assault the fort. Right, bring them in. Where are those fresh regiments? Here they are. Got fresh regiments which to assault the wall. which will come in from two different distinct... Whoa, they've got rocket troops. Not acceptable at all. Please don't tell me you just... Damn you. Far too many troops here to these lazy bastard. Break them, lads.
Yes, sir. Attack!
Rats. Move, gentlemen, move. We're not going to lose this battle now. Just, oh, don't you dare. Don't you dare. harder, lads. Yes. Yes, we did it, my friends. We did it. Well done, General Cobb. Well done, sir. I salute your bravery of yourself and of your troops. An excellent defensive battle, sir. Excellent. We lost 1,000. We came out with 2,110. Look at that. Many kills. 230 with the Royce Welsh Fusiliers. What a wonderful sight. That's okay. That's absolutely fine. At least we can know the disposition of there. We'll retreat. We'll just retreat. They can follow us. That'll pull their ships out of the way. And they can follow us. No, they can't. We should retreat there as well. Look at that, all the way back out to the Mediterranean. They won't follow us there. Wow, that's a long journey. Oh, that was a magnificent fight. It really was. What a fight to come. What more fights are to come yet still? Who knows? Who knows? There they are. There it is. This is the fight. This is a real pivotal fight here now. Istanbul. Now if we can take this, this will be the battle end all battles. It really will. What a fight we've got in prospect here. What a fight. General K. Mendoza and indeed General Adam moving in to take what is the absolute key, the pivotal city here in the entire south. If we can take Istanbul, what a prize that would be. It really will establish here us here firmly on the sort of southern Mediterranean, as it were. Really will. From there, who knows where this will lead, but we have to win this battle first, my friends. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. But I'm going to end this episode here, my friends. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, please comment, like and subscribe. And as always, my friends, please keep your comments coming down below, because believe me when I say to you, and I don't tell you this just for the sake of it, you really have pulled this campaign around to the point where we are now. Your support, your advice, your help, your planning, your strategies have done it. This is you. This is what you have done, my friends. This is where you've put us right here now. It's not just me. It's 10% me, 90% you. Believe me when I say that. You have put us here. So as always, please keep those comments coming down below. And when I start creating more armies, we start building more armies, then more of you will become generals and we will flourish, my friends. We will see a brand new British Empire here flourishing from the Mediterranean and outwards. Who knows? Who knows where that might lead? Russia, maybe? Who knows? France? Who knows? But we've got to, before we think that far in advance, we have to deal with what's in front of us. And that is these very, very powerful Polish forces. But because we've been able to siege them, they've got to come out to us, which gives us the chance to be able to defend and absolutely butcher these armies here. If we can take this, who knows, it might even give the French the sort of freedom to be able to take to attack the Polish in the Eastern Front, and that will then drain troops away from here. And who knows where we'll end up. But my friends, that is for next time. Hope you've enjoyed it. Whatever you do, my friends, please be safe, please be careful. Hope you have a good week coming up now. Hope your Monday goes well. But until next time, my friends, when I can promise you another massive battle. Until then, my friends, bye for now.